Hello everyone, welcome back to Chunda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a crisscross top with long mesh sleeves. And for this top, it is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. For this top, it can fit for size small and size medium because we have the back corset to adjust the top. And in this video, I also showing you how to make the top bigger and longer for any size. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the underbust part. To begin, make a slip knot. For crochet this top, I'm using 2.5mm hook. And chain a multiple of 6, so I make 126 chain. It is equal 22 inches. It's the measurement around my underbust. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more chains by multiple of 6 chain. Remember, please don't make it too fit around your underbust. Just leave some space because we have to make the back corset. It is easy to adjust the top. So I already made my underbust and bust part. And for this short foundation chain, it is just a sample showing you how to crochet the stitches. You guys can follow the description that I show in this video. After you got your desired fit, next for row 1, skip 4 chains and make double crochet into the 5th chain. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And for this chain 4 that we skipped, also count as a stitch. Keep making double crochet into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 2, chain 3. For chain 3, also count as a stitch. Turn your work and skip the stitch that near your chain 3, and we are going to make single crochet into the next stitch. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 2. Then skip 2 stitches and we are going to make double crochet into the 3rd stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 2. And make another double crochet into the same stitch. And now you must have 2 double crochet with chain 2. And this is called as a V stitch. Next, chain 2 and keep repeating this by skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the 3rd stitch. Then continue make chain 2 and skip 2 stitches and make V stitch into the 3rd stitch. Keep repeating this until you have 1 last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you had one last stitch, then we are going to make the bow crochet into that last stitch. And this is what the second row looks like. Next, for row 3, chain 3. Turn your work and make the bow crochet into the single crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, and we are going to make the bow crochet 2 together into this V stitch. To make the bow crochet 2 together, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the same loop. And now you have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we made the bow crochet 2 together. Next, chain 2. And we are going to repeat the same thing into these 3 stitches for 2 more times by make the bow crochet 2 together. And then chain 2 and make another double crochet 2 together into the same stitch. And now you must have 3 groups of double crochet 2 together into the same stitch. Then chain 1, skip this chain space, and we are going to working the stitch into this V stitch by repeat the same thing like the first stitch that we did. Keep repeating this into every V stitch until you have 2 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. For the last stitch of the bow crochet 2 together, you don't have to chain 1, just continue make the bow crochet into the single crochet stitch. And make another double crochet into this chain 3 stitch. And this is what the third row looks like. Next, for row 4, chain 3. Turn your work and make double crochet into this double crochet stitch. Then chain 1, and we are going to make double crochet into this chain space. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1 and make double crochet into the next chain space. Keep repeating this by chain 1 and make double crochet into the chain space until you have 1 last stitch, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you have one last stitch, then we are going to make the bow crochet. It's okay if the fourth row looks like ruffle or tight after we made row 5 and it turned to normal. Next, for row 5, chain 3. Turn your work and make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Then continue make double crochet into the chain space. Keep repeating this by make double crochet into every stitch and into every chain space until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what the fifth row looks like. Next, for row 6 until row 9, please repeat row 2, 3, 4, and 5. If you guys want your under bust part longer, please add more rows by repeat this set of row 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next, we are going to make the bust part. For the bust part, I'm using 2 loop stitch. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is for row 1, chain 4. Remember, for the first chain, please make it a little bit loose. After you got 4 chains, then turn your work. And we are going to make 3 double crochet into the first chain. After you got 3 double crochet into the same loop, then skip 3 stitches and make single crochet into the 4th stitch. After you have made single crochet, then chain 3. And we are going to make 3 double crochet into the same stitch with single crochet. After you got 3 double crochet into the same stitch, then skip 3 stitches and we are going to repeat the same thing like the first stitch by making single crochet into the 4th stitch. Then chain 3 and make 3 double crochet into the same stitch with single crochet. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. So for my last stitch, I only have 3 stitches remain. So I'm going to skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the last stitch, which is the chain 3 stitch. And this is what the first row of tulip stitch looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 4. Turn your work and we are going to make 3 double crochet into the first chain. Then skip these 3 double crochet stitches and we are going to make single crochet into this chain 3 space. After you have made single crochet, then chain 3. And make 3 double crochet into the chain 3 space. After you got 3 double crochet into the chain 3 space, then skip this 3 double crochet stitch and we are going to working the stitch into the chain 3 space by repeat the same thing like the first stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. For the last stitch of the second row, skip this 3 double crochet stitch and make single crochet into this chain 3 space. And this is what the second row of tulip stitch looks like. Next, we are going to separate the bust part into 2 pieces by fold this into 2 pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of it. Make sure that you mark at the chain 3 space. Next, for row 3, please repeat row 2 until you reach the stitch near stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made 3 double crochet into the chain space, then we are going to make single crochet into the chain space that we use stitch marker to mark. And this is what it looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 13. It is equal 5 inches width. It is the measurement from my underbust until the underarm. If you guys want your bust part longer, please add more rows by repeat row 2. After you reach row 13, next we are going to meet the straight edge. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 14, chain 3. Turn your work and make the double crochet into this double crochet stitch. After you have made the double crochet, then we are going to make half the double crochet into the next stitch. To make half the double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. After you have made a half double crochet, then we are going to make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then make slip stitch into the chain 3 space. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this by make double crochet, half double crochet, single crochet into these double crochet stitches. And make slip stitch into the chain 3 space until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the row 14 looks like. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the other side by start from the middle part. To begin, attach the yarn into the chain space that we use stitch marker to mark. Then chain 4. Next, we are going to make 3 double crochet into this chain 3 space. After you got 3 double crochet into the same stitch, then we are going to skip these 3 double crochet stitches and make single crochet into the chain 3 space. Then chain 3 and make 3 double crochet into the chain 3 space. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 13. It is equal 5 inches. It is the same measurement like the first side. And after you reach row 13, next, for row 14, we are going to make the straight edge by repeat the same thing like the first side too. So for the same pole piece, the stitches of both sides is the same number. For the left side, I have 5 groups of tulip stitch. And for the right side, I also have 5 groups of tulip stitch the same. And this is what my top looks like. But for my top, the right side, I have 15 groups of tulip stitch. And for the left side, I have 16 groups of tulip stitch. It's okay if it's not equal because we make different size. So some are equal and some, like mine, it's not equal. Next, we are going to make the sleeves. To begin, count 5 groups of the tulip stitch from the corner and then use stitch marker to mark at the 5th group stitch. And for the measurement from the corner until the stitch that you mark, it is equal 3.5 inches. If you guys want your chest part more wider, please count more stitches and mark it. And then we are going to count the same number to the other side. And this is what it looks like. So this is the front part of the top, and this is the underarm part. Next, I'm going to start with the right sleeve first. For the right sleeve, we are going to attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark to make the strap. Then continue make 65 chains. It is equal 11.5 inches. If you guys want your strap longer, please add more chains. Make sure that your foundation chains is the odd number. After you got 65 chains, next we are going to connect the chain into the corner part. Make sure that your foundation chain doesn't twist. We are going to make slip stitch to connect the foundation chain. Continue insert the hook into this last stitch. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. And this is what your foundation chain looks like. Turn your top like this, and we are going to make slip stitch into this edge of the top. Flip your top like this and make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches. After you had 3 stitches of slip stitch, next, for row 1, turn your work like this, and we are going to make the bokeh shade into this foundation chains. Keep making the bokeh shade into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to connect the strap into the top by skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the 3rd stitch. Next, we are going to continue make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches. After you have made 3 stitches of slip stitch, then for row 2, turn your work and we are going to make double crochet into these double crochet stitches around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to connect the strap into the top by skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the 3rd stitch. Next, continue make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches to start the new row. Next, for row 3, turn your work and this is what the strap looks like. So start from row 3, we are going to make the mesh stitch. For crochet the mesh stitch, you have to switch to 3.5mm crochet hook. To begin, make double crochet into this first double crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you have made the bokeh straight into the last stitch, then we are going to connect the row into this edge by skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the 3rd stitch. Next, continue make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches to start the new row. After you have made slip stitch, for the next row, please keep repeating row 3 until you reach row 6. And for you guys that make different size, like bigger top than me, please keep repeating row 3 until there is no stitch left at the edge or at the underarm part to make slip stitch, or until you have 3 last stitches at the edge, then I will meet you back again. And this is what my sleeve looks like after I reach row 6. As you can see, I still have 3 stitches left at the underarm part after I have made slip stitch. Next, for row 7, chain 2, turn your work and make mesh stitch into every stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this chain 2 stitch. After you reach the end of the row, so we are going to continue make mesh stitch by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make the bokeh straight into the next stitch. Then chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make the double crochet into the next stitch. If you still have more stitches left, keep repeating this until there is no more stitch left or until you reach the stitch near chain 2. Then we are going to make slip stitch into the stitch that you mark. After you have made slip stitch, for the next row, please keep repeating row 7 until you reach row 56. It is equal 22 inches. It's the measurement of my sleeves. If you guys want your sleeve longer, please add more rows by repeat row 7. And this is what my sleeve looks like. Like I said, if you guys want your sleeve longer, please add more rows. Next, we are going to make the crease around the sleeves. So for row 1, chain 1, turn your work and make the crease by make single crochet 2 together into the chain space. To make single crochet 2 together, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next chain space, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and push through all 3 loops. And this is how we made single crochet 2 together. After you have made the crease, then make single crochet into the next chain space. After you have made single crochet, then keep repeating this by make 1 stitch with the crease and 1 stitch with single crochet around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first decreasing stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 2, turn your work and we are going to make increase by make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. After you got 3 double crochet in the same stitch, then we are going to keep repeating this into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 4, chain 2 and make double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. This is what the wrist part looks like after you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the left sleeve. For the left sleeve, we are going to attach the yarn into the corner part. So for making the strap, I'm using 2.5 mm hook. Attach the yarn into the corner stitch. Then continue make 65 chains, it is equal 11.5 inches, it is the same measurement like the right sleeves. After you got 65 chains, then we are going to connect this chain into the stitch that you mark. Make sure that your foundation chain doesn't twist. Continue make slip stitch into the stitch that you mark. And for the next part, we are going to repeat the same thing like the right sleeves. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what my left sleeve looks like. So for my left sleeve, at the strap part or at the underarm part, I make 5 rows of mesh stitch until I have 3 stitches left at the underarm part. The reason why the left sleeve have more stitches because the left bust part, I have 16 groups of tulip stitch like I said before, and the right side I have 15 stitches. But the number of the row of the left sleeve, I make it 56 row the same like the right sleeve. And also the number of the mesh stitch is the same like the right side too. Next, we are going to make single crochet as the border at this side edge. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Next, for row 1, make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the tulip stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the tulip stitch, then we are going to make single crochet into this space and into this double crochet space. Keep making single crochet into each double crochet space until you reach the strap part, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the strap part, then we are going to continue making single crochet into this double crochet space, as you can see, until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then continue make slip stitch into the next 2 stitches. Next, for row 2, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the middle part at the back of the sleeves. As you can see in this picture, you don't have to make the perfect measurement, just guessing it. After you reach the back part of the sleeves, then we are going to make the corset holes. Then continue chain 2, skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 3 stitches. Keep repeating this by chain 2, skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 3 stitches until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. For the last corset hole, you must end with a single crochet. And then make slip stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into the single crochet stitch. Then make 2 single crochet into this chain 2 space. Keep repeating this by making single crochet into each single crochet stitches. And make 2 single crochet into the chain 2 space until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then continue make slip stitch into this edge and chain 1, cut off the yarn. And this is what the corset hole looks like. For the right side, please attach the yarn into the front part and repeat the same thing like the left side. And now your top almost done. For the next part, we are going to weave in the lace into this front bust. For making the lace, you just make a slip knot and make foundation chains long enough to tie at your neck. And for the back lace, you have to make it really long and then weave in the lace into this back corset holes. And now your crisscross long sleeve top is done. For this top, you can wear it in two styles. The first style is the crisscross style. We cross the lace at the neck. And for the second style is the front ruched top. If you guys love this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.